Good morning, and happy Friday, and happy New Year. We're so blessed to be part of your Friday morning. Please stand for the morning prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Now, after the Magi had left, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up, take the child and his mother, and flee to Egypt, for Herod is about to search for the child to destroy him." When Joseph got and went to Egypt, he remained there until the death of Herod. When Herod died, an angel of the Lord suddenly appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said, "Get up and go to the land of Israel, for those who are seeking the child's life are dead." There he made his home in a town called Nazareth, so that what he had spoken through the prophets might be fulfilled. He will be called a Nazarene. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The Prayer of Saint Michael. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Now our kindergarten friends will lead us in the pledge.
Please join us in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic which stands one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Unfortunately, there are no birthdays today.
Welcome to 2019. There's no rest for the weary in our school. Since returning from the break, we have hit the ground running. Sophia, I heard you and a few of your classmates went to New York City on Wednesday. Would you like to share?
Most certainly, but I cannot give away too much information as we will be featuring our next week's trip on the Shine a Spotlight. However, I can tell you that we met someone famous.
Famous? Ooh, I can't wait to hear the details.
Speaking of the spotlight, let's go to John in the Together We Shine studios. John?
Thank you, Sophia and Kaylee. Since our first broadcast, the student council has been inundated with classes telling us of the great things happening in their classrooms. What a fantastic problem to have. However, we did have to make a decision. So envelope, please. Dim the lights. This week, we would like to shine our spotlight on the fourth graders. They have been reading and raising money for the great cause. Let's go to Hannah for more. Hannah?
Thank you. As you heard, this week we are shining the spotlight on our fourth graders. They have done something truly amazing during Advent. Joining me today is fourth grader Ava Abuzo. Hello, and thank you for joining us.
It's my pleasure.
So, Ava, inquiring minds want to know, what is the amazing service your class performed during Advent?
Every month, our class is assigned a book report. However, during Advent, we teamed up with an organization called Heifer International and participated in the Raise a Feed program. Heifer International raises awareness about families living in poverty and provides livestock and schooling for girls to struggling and impoverished families around the world.
Wow, and participating in the Raise a Feed program during Advent was perfect, since Advent is a time to focus on giving rather than receiving.
Exactly. So what we did was set a goal, whether it was by the number of books, chapters, or pages that we were going to read. Then we found sponsors who donated money when we met our reading goals. Can you believe how much we raised?
How much? $500?
The fourth grade raised $1,570. And then came math.
Math? I thought this was a reading program.
Well, we had to crunch numbers to see what we could purchase for those in need with the money we raised.
So tell us, what were you able to purchase?
It wasn't an easy task. We first had to make a case about the animal that we thought we should purchase. take a look at an example of how we stated our case.
First is me. I'm a llama. I can help be a guard for your house, and I can provide milk, money, motivation, meat, and manure. Please purchase me.
Hello, I'm a border buffalo. Purchase me for a family. I do so many useful things, like providing manure for fertilizer. I also can pull heavy things for farming. Families can rent me to neighbors for extra money. With that money, people can buy better homes. They can also send children to school. Purchase me.
Oh, hi. I'm a sheep. I once helped tanning Thayer's dad with his soil by pooping. It increased by 1,000%. So purchase me and I'll help you in more ways. And I'm $120.
They're all great and would provide a sustainable amount of source of food. So in the end, what did your class choose to purchase?
We purchased the following. One cow, one water buffalo, one llama, one goat, one pig, one trio of rabbits, one honeybee, two flocks of chickens, one flock of ducks and geese, and to send one girl to school. And after all that, we had $5 left, so we gave it to where it was most needed.
That's remarkable. I'd say a few families were able to have a very Merry Christmas just because your class chose to read. Well, thank you very much, Ava, and let's give a round of applause to our fourth grade for raising $1,570 to purchase animals for families all over the world. They just proved that kids can make a difference. Back to the Together We Shine studio.
Thank you, Hannah. Did I hear that dollar amount correctly? $1,570. Holy moly! Way to go to our fourth graders. Let's give them a round of applause. Simply remarkable. You know, we're fortunate to attend a school that's not only that teaches academic standards, but since we're a Catholic community, at a young age, we learn about our faith and the importance of serving others, as the fourth grade just did prove that. Yes, we may be kids, but we have the power to change the world. If you see the fourth graders in the hallway, please be sure to congratulate them. If your class is doing something amazing, or if you have a favorite quote that you would like us to end the broadcast with, please be sure to let the student council know. Perhaps your class will receive the next spotlight, because together we shine brighter. Back to Kaylee and Sophia in the studio.
That wraps it up for us. Until next Friday, you were made to be awesome, so go out there and make a difference. Thank you, and may God bless you.